Our nation is a busy place. With over 327 million people, there is so much happening all the time. And to do all of those things, work, play, learn, travel, we need energy. Having safe, reliable, and affordable domestic energy is critical to our economy, our way of life, and our nation's security. And one of those options is wind energy. But how does wind energy work? As the wind blows over the airfoil-shaped blades of wind turbines, the turbine blades spin. The blades are connected to a drive shaft that turns an electric generator to produce electricity. Of course, the wind blows onshore and offshore, but winds are generally stronger and more consistent over the ocean. Since higher wind speeds can produce significantly more energy and electricity, there is increased interest in developing offshore wind energy on the United States' outer continental shelf, which typically starts 3 nautical miles offshore. For the U.S., offshore wind is an abundant energy resource, found close to major coastal cities, where over half the U.S. population lives, and where energy needs are high. Offshore wind is an important potential energy source to meet our growing energy demands. Harnessing the wind offshore is not a new idea. Europe has been the industry leader, with the first offshore wind farm developed in Denmark in 1991. And today, many countries around the world are developing offshore wind capabilities. Offshore wind is proving to be an effective source of energy and is contributing significantly to a diversified energy portfolio across the globe. The sizes, types, and number of wind turbines in a wind farm can vary greatly depending on the location, the depth of the water, technological advances, and other uses of the ocean in an area. But how do you develop and manage wind energy resources on the ocean? The Bureau of Ocean Energy Management is responsible for overseeing all energy and marine mineral development in federal waters, including offshore wind. For any proposed development on the OCS, BOEM evaluates the potential impacts on ocean users, historical and cultural resources, and the marine environment. BOEM uses a multi-phased process to grant access to ocean areas suitable for wind energy development. First, BOEM identifies potential areas for wind energy leasing. Some considerations include wind strength, proximity to places that need energy, and other uses of the ocean in the area, like military needs, shipping, and fishing. There are also discussions with stakeholders, tribes, and local, state, and federal government agencies. Then, BOEM gauges industry interest in developing the area and begins reviewing the possible environmental impacts of development. This is the first of many opportunities to provide your insight, which is essential to help identify areas that should be considered for future offshore wind development. BOEM wants to hear from you. Then, BOEM holds an auction, and companies that are interested in developing offshore wind energy submit bids to try to win the right to potentially develop in the area. After leases are awarded, companies conduct surveys and studies to learn more about their lease areas. They submit detailed site assessment plans for BOEM's review. Next, the companies submit a construction and operations plan, or project proposal, for a prospective offshore wind facility. During this phase, BOEM conducts extensive environmental and technical reviews to determine possible impacts before approving or disapproving the plans. Only after all 4 phases are completed can actual construction on the facilities begin. Public engagement, including meetings, comments, and discussions, is a critical component throughout each of these phases. The process to develop wind energy on the ocean takes time, coordination, and consultation. It takes working with people, states, towns, tribes, and current ocean users. It also involves understanding and studying the environment and potential risks. It's not an easy task, but it's an important one. Our nation's need for safe, reliable, and affordable energy continues to grow, and offshore wind can be an important part of our energy portfolio. We need your participation to be informed, ask questions, provide input, and stay engaged.